In this coding session, I will be working on selection sort. I will be doing a sort where this is very easy, and where we go through entire array, the part go through entire array, the remaining part that is not sorted, find the maximum or minimum value in from that array, depending on the kind of sorting we want. We want a sorting where values are in decreasing order, or we want a sorting where values are in increasing order. Depending on that, we are going to find a maximum or minimum value. And with that, start the coding part. And we don't need any boolean value, so I will not use that. Void and find max data start index int index. So int main index is equal to we have to return the index of the minimum or index of the maximum value. So no, I'll do the mean, find the minimum value. So minimum is going to be the let mean value index is equal to start index. And it will go from 4i is equal to start index plus 1. I is less than equal to end index, and move forward to next index. And I will start from the next from the start, because we have already decided that the start index is the minimum value. So there is no point comparing the same value with itself. I will check that if mean value index is no if data mean index is greater than data I, that means that mean value index is I. I will say the selection okay, everything is gone again, so I will start with everything again. We have going to be have minimum value data int start index int end index end index and int mean value index is equal to start index. For int current index is equal to start index plus 1. Index is less than equal to end index, and move to the next array value. This is what it is, and I will check that if data min value index is greater than data current index, then mean value index is equal to current index. So we have updated the mean value because we have found an index where the value is less than the value at the mean value index that we assumed. So we'll keep over and keep updating it, and at the end we will have the minimum value, mean value index. Int data, sorted array. We are going to sort an array, so we need unsorted array. 11, 5, 56, 5, 6, 22, 23, and no, 21, and I will say 7, and int size of array is equal to size of the array divided by the size of data type that it is containing. In this case, it is an integer. That is done, and I'm going to write a function that is going to print an array. Print this array, and I will say print int array with that I'm going to have to pass array size of array. For int is equal to y is equal to index 0, index is less than size of array, and index printf versatile d data index. So we are going to print with a spaces, or maybe we'll say that add semicolon here, but that won't look good because I will have to then do something to remove the semicolon from the last index, so that won't look good. I'll just go with the space, and I will at the end I print the new line character printf. That is done. So we have a function to get the minimum of the array, we have function to print the array, and next we are going to have to implement selection sort. Int data, int size of array, so from going from int index is equal to 0 to index index less than size of array, I will say, then again I will say that what I am going to say that swap data current index min data start index is going to be current index, and I will say, I'll go and say that let us create a variable int end index, because I will have to calculate the value every time if I call that min function. Say index is equal to data index, and current and uh, swap the value. Or I can say that, even better, I can say that this is the minimum index, and min index is not equal to index, then what meta will have to I forgot the part where how we join two lines in array, two lines in a VI editor. Why it's for copying, then what is for J is the right answer, but it's not working, I guess. So capital J. So this is what it is. If it mean index is not equal to index, and then swap the value with mean index, and with declaring this variable. This variable inside the for loop is same as declaring this variable outside the for loop, because this value is going to be loaded and unloaded every time this loop is going to be executed, because this instruction is going to repeat. So minimum index is this. If minimum index is not equal to the current index, I'll say that min index is not equal to current index, then swap the value. And one more thing, if current index not over here, if I say current index because if we consider equal to with the end index, then if current index is equal to in end index, then there is one value, only one value, that is the last value. So there is no point in executing all these instructions in calculating those values, calculating getting the minimum value of one integer is going to be that integer only. So there is no point in executing all these instructions. Min index is equal to this, and if it is not equal to current index, then do not swap. We need to declare create a swap function, takes an array int first index, second index, temp value is equal to data, this data first index is going to have data, second index. So data second index will have data at the temp in the temp value. So our swapping is done, and I will move this here. So our selection sort function is done, and print array function is done also, is done too. So I will first print the array. Print int array data and one more thing. Let me see some navigation commands in Vim editor. So array is printed. I will now I call sort data and size of the array, and it should work. And then I'm going to print the array again. You can see this is what our array is before sorting. It is after that is sorted. That is working perfectly. So I will say move over here and say printf before sorting. I will say better, even better is to say sorted array and unsorted array. So with this coding part, the selection sort part is done, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.